New. We already discussed some things that will be new for you when you start your study, like how you plan your study and how to find nice extracurricular activities and how to combine this with your study. Today we are going to talk about practical stuff like money, a place to live and running a household. Meike, what was the biggest change for you in this area?
Well, how I spend my money. In high school, I could spend my pocket money and the money I earned with jobs on anything I liked. Now I have to spend my money on rent, tuition, books and groceries. Luckily, I get money from my student loan, my parents and my job as a teaching assistant. But I still have to be careful how I spend it all.
So how do you do that?
At one point, I didn't really know what I was spending my money on. So I used an app on my mobile phone to register my expenses. This helped me to find out on what sort of things I spent most of my money. Especially the first months of the study year, you have a lot of extra expenses because you have to buy books and pay the university tuition. It's good to have a little financial buffer before you start the study year. I also got tips from older year students about which study material you need to buy new and which study material you can buy secondhand.
So did you live with your parents first or did you live on your own when you started your study?
When I started my study, I searched for a place to live near the university. This can be quite hard because at the beginning of the year, a lot of new students are doing the exact same thing. I lived with two other students in one house. We ran a joint household where we shared chores like cleaning and cooking.
So did you know how to clean and cook before you started your living on your own?
Yes, I did. However, I did need to learn how to shop for groceries in a more efficient way and how to cook using cheap ingredients. You can save a lot of money if you know which ingredients you still have and make a list before you go shopping. You can also save money by making use of the promotions in the supermarket.
So a lot of students need to work to pay for their expenses. What kind of jobs are interesting jobs for students?
Well, of course the jobs need to pay well. And if you have the opportunity to improve certain skills, that's really great. The university offers quite a lot of interesting jobs for students. For example, helping with promotional activities and teaching assistant jobs. The teaching assistant jobs are in general only open to the students who finished at least 1 year of their study. A lot of my friends worked in restaurants or had Saturday jobs in stores, but you can also tutor or babysit. A very good job can be to program websites or other programs. So if your university offers you possibilities to learn how to code, it might come in handy, as you can use it to get a nice job.
Thank you very much for all your tips.
Yeah, good luck. And if you don't know how to clean or cook, don't hesitate to ask your parents for advice.